A common man sinks deep into the pool of his own disdain and cynicism of the world. His casual conversation catapults the product further into the seemingly bottomless void. Swimming with as much effort as possible, yet his fate does not tremble. So shall he hinder. So shall he.
2 minutes till showtime, Brooks.
How can I respect your authority, Barbara, when you keep wearing those awful high heels?
You can decide to respect me however you want, but if you don't, you will be fired.
Well, my show is the one that pays you, and quite frankly, the vibe of those shoes, they suck. So, fix them.
Showtime. Edwin, how are you doing? Do you need a glass of water?
I think I'm good, thank you.
All right then, let's get moving to the stage.
Edwin Mulford, actor extraordinaire. It is an honor to have you on our show tonight.
Anytime, thank you, Brooks.
Hey, Edwin, I'm a huge fan.
Oh, we studied all your work in film school. Oh, it was delightful. In Hrom? The shoe-throwing scene? Oh. My. Remarkable. Perfect.
Well, I'm glad you liked it. Thank you.
When that shoe flew across the screen, it flew into my heart.
Thanks.
Ready!
Alright, ready, boys?
Yep.
5, 4...
Join Edwin Mulford. The film, Respect the Blind.
Thanks for having me, Brooks.
This is a film that portrays a blind man totally transforming the life of the main character. And you've often said at the beginning of your career that your experiences as a young, poor, straight out of art school student really helped you and influenced your films in that way.
Yeah, I often did say that, and I think I still believe that. You know, being poor, as I called it, taught me what real life was like and
how... Is it true that in Chicago, you roomed with Jaden Cypress?
Yeah, Jaden was my second roommate. I actually met him at a funeral for my cousin, and we've been pretty inseparable ever since.
Inseparable. I love it. Edwin, do you know what your name means in French?
No.
It means one gifted son from the sea. And I use the adjective gifted advisedly in speaking of you.
Wow, name meanings.
Perhaps it's a reference to your sea of riches?
Well then, Brooks, you certainly are not a son of the sea then, I'm sure.
Certainly not. Being a filmmaker must be a harder job than expected. That's why they give you the big bucks.
I just know I would never want to be an interviewer.
And why do you figure?
Well, often in an interview, your job is to encapsulate the guest's personality in under 7 or so minutes. So, it makes sense for where we are at in this one.
Well, we like to go over as long as the interview stays interesting.
Well, to some that could seem intimidating.
The only thing intimidating here is that I'm sitting next to the man who made it all the way to the top and is among one of the most accomplished filmmakers of our time, and also has degrees in finance,
and
sociology, and social work.
I was told this interview would be a bit interesting.
Well, I hope. Only the best for the great city of Toronto.
It's good to see all these people.
Now, let's show you a special look at his soon-to-be-released film, Respect the Blind.
Let's go!
Don't stop, baby. Don't stop, baby. Don't stop, baby.
Don't stop me. I like the way that you move. I do, you know how I shout it, you're killing them hard with them lady pants. Simple elegance, looking better when you dance. Chest to the...
Hey, poor boy, how'd you like the bass?
Hey, how you like the bass back there, poor boy?
Anyway, time to get out.
Why do you call me poor boy?
You're poor. Here, let me help you up.
Oh, you broke my leg!
You stole my money, poor boy. We don't accept that.
We were friends. We sat together on the bus. Look what you've done to me.
Why would you pull a gun on me? What are you, stupid? You're the one that stole the money from me. You took my money away, poor boy. What'd you expect?
Poor boy like me, never you should be able to succeed. That changes today.
What? I have a gun on you.
Your car and wife are at home, right?
Yeah, of course. What are you talking about?
In about 20 seconds, she's gonna open that car door and ignite the explosives in the back. Oh, it's too late now.
What? That's not true.
This is what you've taken away from me, rich man.
No.
The film comes out this Christmas. I personally have watched it, and I loved it. And while that clip might have been a bit inappropriate for younger audiences, I think they can handle it. But after my several viewings of the film, my interpretation led me to a thesis that, if you don't mind, I'd love to share with you right now. Here it is. A common man sinks deep into the pool of his own disdain and cynicism of the world. His casual conversation catapults the product further into the seemingly bottomless void, swimming with as much effort as possible, yet his fate does not tremble. So shall he hinder from this fall into the cavernous abyss. Or shall he reach his futile destination? So, how does my thesis reflect your goals in the piece?
Your interpretation is actually quite interesting, and the script to the film changed my everything, as it seems it has for you. My Uncle George, he actually wrote the film before he...
died. For those of you who don't know, George Philpman passed away unexpectedly, halfway through production. Edwin, you were with him in his final moments. What did he say to you?
Well, that seems quite private, doesn't it?
I'm so sorry. Let's move on to the next question.
He said to do the script justice.
You would have made him proud.
The film was revolutionary.
As we all know, you used to be a comedian in Chicago before you became a director. Bob Skibo even called you the best stand-up comic of the decade. What challenges have you faced in transitioning from a comedic to a very serious career?
I was less nervous about the serious matter of it, more just the subject matter being. I was mainly just nervous that I wouldn't be able to push my agenda.
And what is your agenda?
Honestly, I don't know. Anyways, last week I went to go get this Christmas card, and this one made me chortle. So here, you can have a look at it. It says, "Happy 4th birthday, you crazy little monkey." And I was like, crazy little monkey? What does that have to do with Christmas? Turns out, I was looking at the 4th birthday for crazy little monkeys section, and not the Christmas section. Now that threw me off. You do have 10 seconds to blow out the hot cocoa before it's not good anymore.
That's a great story, Edwin. Our world is practically falling apart, and those who are poor are fending for their lives, while us rich people laugh down on them. Do we deserve a good life? Tonight, we will change this country for good. Stab it in the back. stabs straight into the heart of the problem.
Greg, can we actually show that other clip from the film that we have?
Edwin, I watched your film 6 separate times. It's the best film I've ever seen.
Thanks. Thank you. I appreciate it. Greg, can we get that other clip?
But maybe... Play the second clip, Greg.
Oh, hey, a second clip? I guess I don't even need to pay for promotion anymore.
We're being attacked!
What did you do?
Keep reading.
Edwin and I have a lot in common. Little do I know, but like me, he is colorblind. This doesn't work on those who are, but the similarities do not stop there. We are both in a group of people who take from those in need and live a life of lavishness. For that reason, it is the time for me to be executed for my transgressions of the world. After this, Edwin will be long gone. Those who choose to follow this message shall do the same as Edwin will have done tonight.
That is that. Get on your knees. Let's go. My uncle's final plans won't be carried out if you don't go through with this. Remember this? I can kill the entire audience.
I haven't just seen that movie. I've seen all your movies. How long's everyone gonna be in this trance?
30 seconds, but the police will come and the doors are locked. Someone needs to die in 15 seconds.
Hello? Yes, yeah, this is Brooks Kervlin, famous television host. Yeah, my guest, Edwin Mulford, just put the audience in some sort of trance. Oh, yeah, that's me. Thank you. We just celebrated our 10-year. But you need to get here as soon as possible. He's knocked out, but please hurry. Yeah.
This is sister.
Please, no! I'll do anything! Please don't do this. I have my show. I have so much ahead of me. I can't do it. Please don't do this.
My work here is everything.
That's what I call head over heels. That's a line from the movie.
He got you straight through the heart.
I was just trying to save you. I didn't kill. No.
No, no. He's bad. Thank you. Well, just relax, everybody. Police are on their way. Barbara, are you okay?
I'm fine. Where are my heels?
A common man sinks deep into the pool of his own disdain and cynicism of the world. His casual conversation catapults the product further into the seemingly bottomless void, swimming with as much effort as possible, yet his fate does not tremble. So shall he hinder from the plummet into the cavernous abyss, or shall he continue the effort of a futile destination?
Get rid of bag of dimes, now we bag of rhymes. Body bags, price tags on your forehead. 9 times out of 10, young ends are 9 or 10 when that line becomes thin.
Baby, that's how it goes.